It's absolutely fantastic to have you here for the Entertainment Media Show. You've been enjoying it so far.
Yeah, it's been great. Been God, no tongues.
Cheeky scamp, Craig Charles.
Yes. It's been lovely. We've been really busy this morning. Met some great folk. It's always nice to be here and sort of get feedback from people as well. You know that how much they're enjoying Game of Thrones, which is a lot of fans. Big Game of Thrones fans. So it's always lovely to meet folk. Yeah.
You've been involved in so many fantastic series and films, but let's start with Game of Thrones. Why do you think people all over the world love this show so much, so passionately?
Well, I think, first of all, the HBO are working from a great base of some fantastic books, which already had a huge fan base. George Martin is a hugely talented writer and has created this amazing world, and HBO, to blow their trumpet for a bit, a remarkable company, because they really get behind a show. They're not scared to spend the money, they're not scared to get all the right people, and once they go for it, they really go for it. And so I think that combination has worked out beautifully, and also Game of Thrones ticks a lot of boxes. You know, it has appeal, a very broad-based appeal. And I think they've employed all the right people, great writers, terrific directors and producers, and a really good cast. And I think they just tick all the boxes.
When you first joined the series, did you have an appreciation for just how big the fan base was and how wide the show was going to impact?
Not really. I don't think anyone did, really, how huge it was going to be, you know, because these things have a life of their own sometimes, you know. They build exponentially. You just can't see it happening, but it has in Game of Thrones, you know, and it's wonderful. It's great.
For anyone who is not as familiar with the series as they probably should be, can you just tell us just a little bit who your character is and where he fits into the very complicated web that is Game of Thrones?
Yeah, it is a hugely complicated web, and I think that's one of the things that appeal to a lot of people, you know, because you really have to pay attention to all the intricate storylines and interweaving storylines. But my character is Jeor Mormont, Lord Commander Mormont, who commands an army called the Night's Watch, who protect the wall, this huge ice and rock wall, many hundreds of meters high, from the outside world, the wilderness that's out there. And outside in that wilderness are the most horrific things, zombies and white walkers and dreadful things out there. And the Night's Watch are an army of, they're a bit like the Knights Templar, a celibate army of warriors, dedicated to protecting the rest of the world from what's outside the wall, and very, very brave, stern army, and he has the honour to be like the 800th commander of them. It's amazing, yeah.
When you first stepped into the role of Old Bear, did you go back to the books, or were you just working off the scripts? I mean, because obviously there's such a wealth of source material.
Yeah. I'm always wary of working from a book when it's been made into a script, because ultimately you have to work from what's on the script, on that page. And the character that the writers may have taken from a book, they may have changed it, they may not, but I'd rather just work from what the writers, what, you know, Daniel and David saw and created. So that's where I like to work, you know. But when you walked onto the set, you felt very comfortable, you know. It was felt really good, yeah.
Clearly the series deals with a lot of dark and heavy subject matter, but what's the atmosphere like on set? What are your experiences like when you're actually making the show?
Well, obviously, it's a really big show. It's important you get it right. But it's also, everyone's professional. So it's a fairly relaxed atmosphere. You know, we all know what we're doing, hopefully. And we get on with it. When you're working, the days are long and hard. And so you've got to keep your eye on the ball. But nonetheless, HBO look after you very well. They care about their actors and their crew. And so they've made it very easy for us. Yeah.
So Talking about the actors, I think Game of Thrones boasts one of the most dazzling array of talent, old and young, in any series on television. What's it like working with some of your wonderful co-stars? Is there anyone in particular that you really just enjoy sharing time with and watching work?
You know, across the, I wouldn't pick out anyone in particular. It's just a joy, as you say, to see such a wide range of talent together. You know, and as actors do, we all sort of bond fairly quickly and get on well together. You know, so yeah, I wouldn't pick anyone out, but it's lovely to work with all of them.
Yeah. Are there any particular bonding activities, any particular scenes that helped you band together a little bit more than others?
No, well, so Lord Mormont is quite a taciturn character. He's quite stern and aloof, and so you sort of kept in that sort of character. You know, the rest of the guys in the Night Watch, the younger ones, they all got to play together, but Lord Mormont always keeps a pace apart from everyone else, so you had to keep that up a bit to intimidate the younger actors. That was the idea.
Keep them in their place.
Absolutely.
Now, of course, fans will have their favourite characters on screen. Apart from your own, are there any particular characters in the show that you just enjoy watching or you're a big fan of?
I love Sean Bean. I think he's a lovely actor. I really enjoyed watching Sean, you know. And every actor in the show brings their own talent. You know, like HBO don't employ schmucks, you know. Everyone's there for a reason, because they're bloody good at what they do.
Aside from great characters, we also have so many fantastic moments in the show. Are there any particular moments so far, or even ones that are coming up, that you're looking forward to seeing brought to life?
Yeah, all I'm going to say is the first scene of the first episode of the new season is going to be my favourite. And I won't say any more.
For all the Game of Thrones fans watching this all over the world, do you have a message for them?
Well, I'd just like to say thank you so much for watching the show. I'm so glad that you enjoy it. It's been a pleasure to work on the show, and continued enjoyment to you. Thank you.